And just want to.
You have to remember which switch is which.
Just press the two of those. Recording, and we've got the camera just over your right shoulder.
Yep.
Just organise it here. Tons in just to make it weigh a bit better. So just there you go. I will refuel this a little bit quicker. So we've now got 30 tons of fuel, right? 15 tons in each tank. And if I bring up fuel on the master display, there's the 15 tons in each tank. We've got nothing in the middle, so the plane can carry a lot more fuel. There's the engines there on this display, and in a moment we're going to start the engines up, and you'll be opening those fuel valves, and that's the fuel valves there. The way you operate them is just to pull them up. Okay. See how I've opened that valve there, and that opens up the fuel supply. So I'll show you how that works in real life. If you turn that knob to the start, and then you pull that fuel valve out, what happens is it starts to wind up the engine electrically, so that's called M1, which is where it's a percentage of power being developed by the engine. When it gets to about 4, it'll actually start to run up here pretty quickly because it's actually introduced fuel. There you go. So and there's your exhaust gas temperature coming on. So that big engine is now winding up. And we can't hear it here because it's way down on the wind. But that's actually winding up now. And when it's idling at a steady state of about 20.6 or 21, we can actually take that back to normal, which is where it's at now, so you take that back to normal, and you can start the left engine. Same way. So that's bringing them online. Well, cargo doors, so from the flight deck you can check what's happening. All the doors are shut and armed, so that's all good. You can check what's happening with all the air temperatures and pressures in the cabin. And also at the same time, it's just telling us that the engines have come online and they're supplying, and that will come online in a minute, and that's going to be supplying ducted into my line, which is what we want. Still winding up. There we go. So disconnected from the auxiliary power unit, now it's running off the wall. So you can take that back to normal. Now, we'll start taxiing in a moment, but I can show you a couple of the main controls that we'll be looking at here. Instrument-wise, we've got the artificial horizon, with the black dot is the cockpit of the plane, and the black lines are the wings, so that's your attitude. And planes, jet airlines in particular, flying modes are about 4 degrees. And if you want proof of that, you see the flight attendant's pushing the trolley uphill from the back of the plane, yeah? So the plane flies about 4 degrees. And in level flight, I'll be getting in a flight that's at about 4 degrees. So see, it's got 0, 2.5, 5, 7.5, and 10. Well, we just want that black dot in level flight just below the 5. When we're taking off, because we actually want to climb, or a plane going a bit steeper, so we want it up at 12.5 or 15. So we'll see how you go. It's hard work, so we'll see how you go. Important thing, mate, is we're a lot busier, we just want you to leave with a smile on your face. So if you feel like you're getting worked over a bit, just let me know and I'll ease up the workload. That also tells you what your bank angle is. So what you're banking at. And on airliners, they tend, or they not tend to, they do interconnect the rudder and the ailerons. So you're not going to have to use the pedals unless we get further into your flying experience, and then, you know, if we're having a bit of a hairy crosswind landing, something we might start looking at how the pedals work for you. Until then, it's not going to be an issue. Because what we'll do is we'll take off from here, we'll fly straight out, we'll do some handling and control exercises and things, and then we'll try some landings and more takeoffs. Now, I've got a laser beam here, so I'm going to go. So I can actually point the things in here, but I can also point outside, which is handy. And way over on your left, you can see a yellow line running out that way. We're going to taxi out along that yellow line because that's the runway threshold there, and then we're going to get ready for takeoff. So we've got the engines running. We'll take those brakes off. You can take that handbrake off, so push that down. And the way you move these aircraft on the ground is with a tiller, so you don't actually use this. You steer the nose wheel with a tiller and you use the flat of your hand, and you go over to that firewall and you put the flat of your hand on that firewall. And then if you take it around to the left to 7 o'clock, so just take it around as far as it'll go actually. What you're doing is you're steering the nose wheel, and then you can just put a little bit of power into the right engine. So just start edging that forward. And we want about 25% N1. So just keep a little bit more, and you'll see it start to move. There you go, get away from the engine. They take a long time because they're big engines. So the issue is coming around, so you hold that tiller down. And you let it off very, very slowly. So you just let the tiller, when you're ready, you just let the tiller come back super slowly. Because the nose wheel is behind you and it's direct connected. But that's it. Beautiful job. Pick her up on the yellow line so the wings don't hit down the lines. Then we're just going to attach you straight out to that port, and you can put a tiny bit of power into the left engine too if you like. just give it time to catch up and just a little inputs.
Doing
more on the left engine. And then that'll make life easier, because at the moment, your right engine's doing more thrust. So there you go. So that'll probably steer a little bit more easily for you. And Josh, over on that corner, see where it says GS 10 or 11?
Yeah.
That's ground speed, 11 knots, 12 knots, which is building up a little bit of speed. And what you can do is you can back that power back off again. And once you get to the middle of the runway, we'll do a left turn, just taxi down the runway.
Approaching 1-3.
There you go, that's Mr. Bar. So a bit of right engine. Tail down, get on the middle of the runway.
On runway 1-3.
So the female voice, Mrs. Boeing, always tells you the happy news or stuff you'd like to know, or what runway you're on, stuff like that. There's also a male voice that tells us the information we don't want to know. If we hear him, we'll generally ignore him anyway. So rolling down the middle here. Now, runways get the numbers from the direction they face on the compass. I don't know if you knew that or not, but we're on runway 1-3, which faces at 135 degrees. So they use the first two digits. Right, it's at 135 degrees. And actually, what we've got on the display in front of you here is that pink coloured line. Now, the white triangle at the bottom is us, and that's the plane. The solid white line is just a straight line running in from the plane that's basically the same. And that pink line is selected by what hand we want to go out on. See how it's moving here? So 135 is the heading we want to go out on. And it's also the runway heading. So if I put on a little bit more light power and we just walk this round a bit. And we can get ready for takeoff. So what we'll put on is 15 degrees of flight. So we've selected 15 degrees, and that white block means that the flaps are now coming down off the back of the wings at that speed. We'll set the brakes for rejected takeoff. And rejected takeoff means that the lower certain speed we can actually stop the plane by just putting the engines in reverse. And what that does is, see if the revs are not possible in reverse. And what it does is it also applies the brakes and the speed brakes. And I'll explain in flight what the speed brakes do. So what that speed is called V1. V1 is the speed you get to where you call V1 and you've calculated the speed. And today it's 130 knots. That's a speed where you're going to fly even if an engine falls off the plane, because it's safer being than on the air. You can't stop in time, you're just going to have to bend it. V2 is rotate, and that's 140 knots. So generally close to each other. And rotate is when we just got the control column, and we pull it back, and the nose starts to come up, and we start to climb out. And we're going to try and climb it at 15 degrees. A lot to take in, isn't it? So, but if you feel like I'm overweight, you just let me know. So, what we can do, I'll apply the foot brakes for you. But you can take the park brake off, so set that off, and you can take the throttles up to halfway, because we want to make sure that the engines are actually producing power. So just push them forward to halfway, about halfway. See how they're predicted? Like, there's a line that says where they're going to get to. That's because these engines are so big that it does take them a while to produce power. So I'm going to take the feet off the brakes. We're at half power, and it's going to start the plane moving. You can take the power to full power, and hands on the control columns. Control column. I'll keep this on the runway. Airspeed's active. So we've got airspeed here that's telling us how fast we're going. 80 knots. V1 and rotate. You can pull back on the control column and see what you'll notice is see how the nose is starting to come up on your instrument.
Positive
flight. Brakes off. Flap away, power back to 80%. And you've got a very nice climb going on there, mate. Excellent work. Excellent work. You know what the evidence of that is? That at a reduced power setting, we're accelerating in the climb. Because most people climb out too steeply. As dear as they were, those people that were here a little bit earlier, were climbing like that. So what we'll do is we'll set our, so we'll set our speed for 250 knots. And we'll set the auto throttle, because we don't really want to have to worry about doing this all the time. We're going to be up and down, that's what the plane did for us. Climbing through 4,500 feet, so you'll notice we're climbing very well, nearly 5,000 feet over there. And we're going to climb out to 10,000 feet on this heading. So what you can do is just try a little bit of left hand down turn and just see if you can bring the plane to converge onto that pink heading. See how she's coming around for you?
Yeah.
So you're actually flying onto that 135 meter. Don't worry about that noise, that's just a navigation noise for an hour, mate. Mate, you should be quiet. You thought about it?
No.
Not pretty well. 8,000 feet, 15 degrees, you're on here. Most people can't get that first time out. 9,000 feet. So right now you can start to push forward a little bit because we'll roll out at 10,000 feet. So if you push forward, remember we're talking about 4 degrees nose up. So if you just keep pushing forward. Hold it forward, as you can see your nose coming down here. So that's 11 degrees, 10, 9, 8, 7.5, 6, 5, there's your 4. And what you'll notice magically is that the your altitude starts to stabilize. So you've climbed through 10,000, but that's all right. Point is, see how you're pretty much at 11,400 feet now, and it's going to stay there as long as you keep it trimmed like that. And the evidence of that is that your engines have now taken the power right down into the 50s, which is where these have got the best rate of cruise. Now, next thing about flying a plane, get your right hand, stick it on your right thigh, go like that. That's how you fly a plane. When you have a little control column, all your press-to-talk, autopilot, trim switches, are on the left, on my side, they're on the right, they're on the outboard side of the plane. That's so that on the inboard hand, you've got all this crap. You've got all this stuff, you've got all that stuff, and so you fly one-handed. The other good thing about it, Josh, is you fly two-hand, you tend to become a part of the plane, rock and roll with it, and it doesn't feel right, whereas if you sit in there and you see your hand on the thigh, on the throttle, or wherever you want to put it, and you're just flying with one hand, you're actually commanding the plane to do something instead of being part of it. Makes sense. So the next thing is, as we're climbing out, you're doing a beautiful job on this. This is fabulous. Anything we've selected up here is pink. So you've got these magenta or pink colours. And these are cool. This is your flight management. Three things you need when you fly. How fast is that going? What's your heading? What's your altitude? So there are your three numbers there. We're flying manually, but with the exception of autopilot. But we always put those numbers in, so we've got a rough idea of what our heading is. Make sense?
Yep.
Your channel, you're going very well. So what we can do, if you like, is try a couple of maneuvers like turns, and you could turn your heading bug to the right to 210, so start just turning that around, and you'll notice that my pink line starts to move. That's it. then, remember what I said about 4 degrees nose up, and that they tend to drop their nose in a turn?
Yeah.
Just try turning to the right or the head, and see if you can keep it 4 degrees and not losing the balance. Nice turn. So what you can do is you can make your turn a bit more shallow to rescue yourself, because the wings start lifting up more than out. Or else you just pull back on the stick, and it depends whether you're flying a freight line or a peasant. This freight won't consider the peasant. A plane load of lawnmowers won't keep. Coming around onto your heading, and you just gradually roll out. You've just got a hold of this. So it's a bit tricky. Well, you lost about 1,200 feet in that turn. So they do drop their nose a bit. Pretty interesting, the airlines, when they interview pilots now for jobs, one of the things they get them to do is steeper turns than that. They want to see if the pilot knows how to do a turn without losing the altitude. So, funny thing, you know, if I'm talking Cathay Pacific, Singapore Airlines, all that, all they want to know is can you fly a plane. They don't care if you can fly a computer, you know, like a put in fly planes. If everything's down to the line, so the interview is now all about that. Alright, that's pretty good. Right up in your main screen there, see where it says heading 215 on the top of the middle. So go over to your left, now you've got a ground speed of 274 knots and a TAS, that's your true airspeed. So you're doing 275 knots over the air. You're doing 285 knots in the air. Why is that? Well, directly underneath it is your answer. You've got a wind coming from 272 degrees at 21 knots. And the arrow underneath it is telling you the direction the wind's coming from. So it's going forward that way. So if you look at that at being roughly 45 degrees, which means it's cut for 21 knots coming from that direction. It's probably about 10 knots on the nose. And therefore, if you look at the difference between the ground speed and the true air speed, well, imagine, look at that, it's about 10 or 11 knots.
Yeah.
So we're flying along in the air a bit faster than we're going over the ground, because aeroplanes fly in a pocket of air, and that pocket of air is actually moving at 21 knots from that direction. Fill away. If you want to try another right turn, we could go to 310 degrees for right. It's a bit different. I think you realise that. You set it up, but then you put the wheel back to the middle. Whatever you turn up, whatever you set up, that's the attitude. So what we're doing now, we've taken off upwind from Kaitak Airport. Done a little bit of handling. We've climbed up to 10, 11, 12,000 feet. Turned right. So we've flown at right angles to where we took off from. Now, turn right again, so we're flying downwind from Hong Kong. And Hong Kong's, tell you what it is. Thirty-eight miles that way. So you've got it.
There you go.
So you have VHHX.
Yeah.
That's where we took off from. VHHH, which is up to the left of it, is the new Hong Kong airport. And VMMC, which is the one we're sort of in, is a place called Macau. So we've got Macau on the nose, but we won't go to Macau. What we'll do is a couple of practice landings at VHHH. See how we go, and that could be exciting because there's traffic turning on there, so we might see a few other Cathay Pacifics or scooters or something like that. And get ourselves set up for a landing there, what do you reckon?
Yeah.
And on the way, if you want to practice any turning or weaving, we've got 38 miles to run, we're going about. So we've got about 8 minutes to where we need to be making some decisions. So just have a get a feel for it. Get Mother Bear happy, put an answer on for her.
Ladies and gentlemen, the flight attendants will shortly be making their way through the cabin to offer various beverages of your choice. There will also be a selection of goods available for purchase, and we can accept most credit cards, checks and cash. If there's anything we can do to make your trip more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask. Now we'd like you to sit back, relax and enjoy the flight.
It's too easy, mate. You're not really deviating from altitude too much. You've got your 4 degrees nose up. See, if you wanted to climb now to 10,000 feet, what you'd do now is you just pull it back up to about 7.5 degrees. And if you do that, you'll notice that the auto throttles will just start to put power in for you. So there's your N1s going up. And you do it nice and smooth, and your passengers don't even know you've done it. Usually happens on commercial flights, you know, they'll do the first leg of the flight at 34,000 feet or something. Once they've burned off enough fuel, they can actually climb up to 4,000 or 5,000 feet. When the air's smoother, they can also fly a little bit more economically, so it's important. Clouds coming up here to fly through, so you get a feel for some instrument flying. Except for that 1% of the time, we're really glad they're there. Say, if you took us down to 1 degree, so that black square is basically just in the blue, nearly in the brown. So it just kind of formed to me there. Subtracted 40 degrees from there, flew 270, and in fact the runway direction is 250, so it makes it turn left to 250. So the runway we're going to land on at Hong Kong is runway 07 right. So if you've got two runways next to each other, one's always going left, the other's going right. You can imagine. And if you get three, there's you get left centre of the line. So what we want to do is land on 07 right. So if we want to fly right angles to that runway, what we need to do is turn right to a heading that's right angles to the runway. So take 90 degrees off 07. 340 is your number. So I turn right to 340. Such good hand-eye coordination control. You ride motorbikes or drive go-karts or something. I'll tell you what, you're better than most. Right, so there's your heading. So heading's important. 4 degrees is important to it. Now as you roll out of the turn, it's going to lift up anyway. See how it's lifting up? Do those massive wings. So the airport is just on the other side of this island, and you can just see the island that the airport's on, just poking its nose out there. So get ourselves set up for a proper approaching there, and which to me I was sitting on about 18 miles, about 300 feet per mile. It's about 5,500 feet, so probably don't want to descend anymore just yet. We'll just keep it 4 degrees nose up. And what you can do though is you can take your speed down to 220. So see where it says 250 on the knob there at the moment. Just take that down to 220. What that's saying on the ambulance is we don't want to be powerful on the police until we're down to 20 knots. So it's buttoned off your V1, your M1. Okay, the airport over there, that's Hong Kong International Airport. The white splotch there will become more apparent as we get closer. That's the apron, the parking apron between the runways. So the runway we want is on this side of that splotch and runs away 07 degrees. So because we're still descending, just probably start a nice right turn, I think, onto 072. So start that turn now. Set your bug to 072. And just keep your nose up and don't descend. Shallow turn, and just back up to 4 degrees. Right, there's your runway. So just cease your turn from your go to wings level. So just roll out of the turn, and we're going to fly across the line running from that runway. So the runway comes out in this direction. We want to intersect a point where it's coming out from the runway. And then we'll continue our turn on to 072. And what we'll also do is keep sliding the plane down. So with 220 knots, what I can do is actually put on two stages of that. And can you reach the undercarriage lever for a minute? It's fairly physical. If you lower the undercarriage, yep. Undercarriage switches are always physical, so you know they're down. Yep, nose down. Keep your nose going down to 4 degrees. In fact, even a bit more now. 165. Nose down to, remember that 1 degree. So push it forward to that. Turn over that runway. 195. So there's our runway. It's made out pretty clear now, isn't it? See the white lights that are on each side of the runway? What we want to do is descend so that we're probably more descending towards the ocean than the runway. Because when we're at the right angle of attack, we'll start to see some red lights instead of white lights. When they're half red, half white, we're on the right angle of approach. So just push your nose down a bit more. And 155, so I'm slow down a bit more. And when you see a red light come on, so keep it coming down, that's good. When you see one of those lights go red on each side of the runway, we're pretty much getting into the right glide path angle, and you can start to just pull out of the descent a bit. Every time you come into land as a pilot, it gets to a stage where you get to the threshold, and then you look at the end of the runway so you've got perspective. So you don't sort of pile drive straight in the ground. So a little bit of left hand down so you get over to that runway line. Imagine a straight line running out from the runway. Remember I said that there was a male voice that always told you bad news and you don't want to listen to it? Now's the time. 155. We just want to float in. they just going to start to arrest you to send it.
No.
So a little bit of stick back.
Approaching
and
07.
And a little bit of, you can put a little bit of right pedal on if you want to, so you can go one to left. There's your red light. Now look at the end of the runway.
200.
And pull back a bit and go wings level.
100.
That's it. Now take your pedal off.
50.
And a bit of left pedal.
30. 20.
That's it.
10.
Yeah, keep the left pedal. Go for a top effort, first land. And then right pedal. See what those pedals do?
Yeah.
That's all right, you're getting angry. Right pedal. Landing,
approaching
see,
two,
is, the good
five,
landing is one
left.
You walk away from here.
Yeah.
Perfect landing is one where you can use the plane. So
on runway 07, right.
Let's take right
caution
to the left and taxi
short
back
runway,
for another
short runway.
So try a bit of left pedal there because we're still speeding on. Right. And then once we get to here, we'll do a sharp left turn and head back for another takeoff. That feel good?
Yeah.
That was really good effort, mate. You floated that in well.
Yeah.
On top of the left pedal, roll your left foot down. That's it. Hold it down, get your tiller. Hold it down to the left. That's it. I'll put in some right power. And then take off your left brake and hold. Keep your tiller down. Where that other plane is, down there, and take off again. Too easy. Exceptional job, Josh. Seriously, that's very, very good. Very comfortable. You get in these things and you know, and people that either have a feel for it or people that don't, and you've got a really good feel for it. Didn't know that, did you?
No.
Makes me sick. All the effort I had to go to and try and be good at it. And I'll get our flaps reconfigured for the next takeoff. So 15 degrees of flap, auto brakes to reject the takeoff, speed brakes on auto. Now I'm speeding us up a little bit, save time. The tiller steering's just disconnected, so you might put your feet to the bottom of the pedals and steer with your feet. So you push your right foot down, and there you go. Too easy. 37 knots. Yeah, speeding data from the control tower. Great, burnt 4 tonnes of fuel. So not only are we good at this, but we're not able to spend a lot of money on the jets. Now that landing felt pretty good. What if we go around and do another landing here? Get ourselves set up again, and I'll guide you through that. And then we're going to go up to high tech, because that's the funny of what's all in there. Give you a little bit more to do this time, so we've got a plan. Yeah. So you're doing 26 knots, see on the lands wheel, we're doing 26 knots. What you can do is you can, when you're ready to do the turn, slow it down with your foot brakes, so both feet on top of the pedals, and you just push with both feet, slow it down to about 15. All four, put a bit more power back in, and that, and then you can tilt the steerer around onto the runway.
Approaching 07 right.
See, Mrs. Barrett, she just gives you all that advice. Hold that tiller there, so that you, and then when you're on the center line, just gradually bring it back.
On runway 07 right.
Okay, so we've got flaps 15, we've got brakes set to reject the takeoff. You can hold it on your foot brakes now, so you won't use the park brake, but you hold it on your foot brakes. And then, for a bit of sport, what we're going to do is we're going to climb out to 6,000 feet. We've got the runway here, okay? So climb out to 6,000 feet, but what I'd like you to do is set thrust to 85%, so you can get a feel of what it looks like in a heavier plane to get off the ground. So you take your thrust setting through to say 50% now, so you can sitting on the brakes, so make sure your engines are level to the out. Right, oh, we're happy with the engines developing now, yeah, that's fabulous. You take your feet off the brake and put your heels to the floor. So you release your brakes, heels to the floor. You take your power up to 85%, with just a little bit of left pedal to get it get on with that runway. You're holding it on the runway. I'm not doing a thing except telling you what to do. There's your 85%. Thereabouts. That's, mate, that's fat. That's unbelievable. All right, so we 100 knots, 120, V1, rotate. So you pull back now, take her off to 12.5 degrees.
Positive right.
This is going, brakes off. Oh. So 12.5 degrees, flaps 15. We're just inside the speed window. Yeah? So that red line is the maximum speed line. And by putting these flaps up, I'll take them 5. Okay. Shift it. Just starts to speed up, so see, you've got a manual power setting, 206 knots, 207 knots, I'll take away another stage of flaps, it should start to speed up a little bit more, so I'll flaps 1, and that's a demonstration of what we're talking about earlier, so flaps increase lift but also drag, so we've sped up so we don't need as many flaps, so I've put some flaps away and look at the speed creeping up now as we climb, so if I go flaps 1, flaps up from flaps 1, she'll speed up even more. Isn't that a gorgeous aircraft? Just do exactly what you want to do. Now as we're approaching 6,000 feet, going through 4,880, you can start to put pressure on it to drop the nose down and just get it a 4 degrees nose positive attitude. See how you go rolling out at 6,000 feet.
Okay,
18,000
to
3,000. Here's the local. Oh, you're too smart, aren't you? Not a bad effort. 5,900. Okay. now about 60%. If you just drop your right wing for a minute, you'll see Hong Kong where we originally took off from.
Oh, yeah.
And the runway. That's the runway just there. Alright, so 6,000 feet. Back up to 4 degrees. And we took off on runway 07. So if we took 90 degrees off 07 on a compass, what's that number?
Scroll that.
Learn the 3, aren't you, you bugger? 340. Alright, so left turn to 340. See a little bit of the scenery of the Chinese mainland. It's important to do what you're doing, that is you're flying by the numbers and by the attitude, because when it's a jumbo jet, there's no second chances. So 4 degrees of altitude. Just disappearing from view at the left is where we took off from. So it must be about 20 miles. So we've flown upwind. So we took off, we flew upwind. This lead is called crosswind. And presently we'll turn down to set up for another lead. So if that's runway 07, the runway opposite the other direction, going the other direction, would be 25. So if we parallel that, why don't we put in 250 if you're heading? So there's the airport way over there. We're flying downwind, so we've flown upwind off the runway. We've turned crosswind to come out here. Now we've turned downwind. Inserted. We'll fly down past the airport. Most people get tired by then, so I'm going to go up to autopilot, so that Typically, you'd wait till you're 45 degrees off that runway, and that's going to be 6 or 7 miles.
Thank you.
see the height of those other planes, you can see how we're descending okay for that turn at 3,600 feet. They're at about 3,600. And if you looked at runway 07 right, you can probably start your left turn now, nice, because you're doing nice gradient turns. Just take the speed back to 165 now. Now you're flying just by sight, so you sight yourself up on that runway so that your turn comes around onto it. Flaps one. So you know you're a bit above the profile, and those other planes are pretty much on. So just ignore the traffic warning. So you can turn right onto that runway heading, Josh. Does that make sense? It's your plane, mate. I'm just doing nothing but nothing. That's for you. Flaps 25. Speed set at 155. Approach is stabilised. We're a bit high. I'm going to just pick up one of those red lights and then you can do a little bit of a right turn onto that runway heading. Runway heading. 1,000. Flaps 30. Now, when you're coming in like this, as I said, it's like a chairlift approach, but you need to look at the perspective of the runway end as well.
Approaching.
And
zero,
the fact that you,
seven,
you want your main eight. Wheels to hit the runway first, not your nose wheel. Alright, so the plane needs to come down like that.
500.
You're doing all this yourself, mate. There's your first red light, so just keep it going. 100 there. This is fabulous.
300.
Start your flares, so start to flare the plane out, pull back.
100.
Auto throttle disconnect.
50.
20. Left hand down.
10.
Forward, left hand down, push forward, left pedal. Now, tricks for young players. Remember what we were saying about the ailerons bank the plane, but they don't turn it, and the rudder turns it. See how your pedals turn it?
Approaching
two, five, left, on runway, zero, seven, right.
Caution, short runway, short runway.
Thank you. 7 more gas. So we'll do a bit of a briefing for the contact takeoff. What we'll do is we'll take off on the same runway, and we're only going to climb up to about 2,500 feet, and we'll just keep about 5 degrees of flat, and we'll turn right, go out over these hills, and once we're over the hills and over the next body of water, we'll just about turn left straight away, and get ourselves set up. Contact and with contact, it's a curving sort of approach, but it's really good fun.
Yeah.
And I reckon we'll run out. Everyone needs to say that when we're at contact. I'll guide you. If you follow me through, I'll do the landing. If you follow me, you stay in that time frame. And when you go down, you'll be on the shot. I'm just about thinking of this technique.
I'm afraid you're going to have to light 31 to 25,000.
So you're good to go.
I'll let you do everything.
Follow the runway in and out. But what we want to do is virtually turn right straight away.
Approaching 07,
take
right.
Take off to 2500 feet. So you get the take off, and when you're comfy, we'll raise the other carriage and turn right and go over these hills to 2500 feet.
On runway 07, right.
Your aircraft. Just heels to the floor and steer with your foot. That's it. Perfect. Good power settings. Well done.
80 knots.
80 knots. Whole thing visual. And what you'll see out to your left at 10 o'clock now is Hong Kong, the city. And if you start a left turn now, right there, you see the white back of the ship and the white back of the ship? There's a ship there and a ship there, there and there. Straight between them at 1,400 feet, right? So you've got a little bit of height to lose. But if you can get straight between them and be at 1,400 feet, I'll be in power settings. Runway begins over there and runs out that way. So your objective at the moment is flying with this checkerboard. See, you've got your red and white lights on the runway, so you're on the right approach, you're on the right height. Right now you're on the perfect height. Now remember, she drops her nose on the turn. So three red lights are a wee bit low. But what you don't do is don't climb. Just don't descend, because you know that there's a descent line. There you go, you've met it again already, so keep coming down, keep pushing down, keep your turn on. A little bit tiny little bit high, but keep your turn on.
400.
There you go, wings level, look at the end of the runway, keep your nose wheel off the ground, wings level, that's it. Announce panel if you need it. That float you've got now is perfect. A little bit of tiny bit of nose down. That's it, middle left pedal, tiny bit of tip.
30.
10. No one's ever done that before. Seriously, you just did what you were told. Can't believe it.
Manual greeting. Approaching on runway 3.
And then Phil.
Short runway. Short runway.
To do a contact landing like that is just unbelievable. Like, no one's done that before. Like, first time. But seriously, it's really, really good. So let's do the U-turn and head back down there. Takeoff, increase the degree of difficulty for that. Just pull off to the runway to the left and I'll put the land brake on and I'll just make a couple of changes. Just take a counter into the left. Oh, wonderful. So what we'll do this time is we're going to take off at night, obviously, and we'll do a circuit, just a low level 5,000 foot circuit around, keep it tight, around the place. We'll just stay at flaps 5, and so we're going to have a bit of maneuverability. Session on a night time circuit,
better than the plane in the cop.
No?
Better than the plane in the cop.
Flying, but the good thing about flying around Hong Kong is there's still lots of light references.
Yeah.
And stuff, so. And there's no traffic at the airport. Turn it off so we can get peace and quiet. Taxi lights coming in. So here's your 135 heading on your runway.
On runway 13.
Master display. We're going to fly up to 5,000 feet, turn right to 210, turn right to 310, and fly visually back on the runway. So, 85% power setting, and your aircraft. What happened on the flight deck normally is the captain would say set thrust and I would know that it's 85%.
Yeah.
And I'd get the finale and say thrust set.
80 knots.
And you need to do it by the time you're doing 80 knots. So we've just got it in time.
Positive rate.
Positive rate, gear up. fabulous. So when you're flying out into the black, all of a sudden instruments become your friend.
Yep. Change that to 2-10.
Not yet. But you know what? Change it to 210 and just keep doing a climbing turn. And create this climbing turn. So keep your climb up and turn over that head. So the wing's level now, we're a beam Hong Kong, you can start your descent, so push forward to 113, pretty much where you're just above the ground, that's it. We'll hold it there. So we're flying downwind now, Josh. The runway we took off from is right there. Okay? So we're flying downwind and we've got to keep the altitude peeling off, so just keep it down at that trim level. We've got 3,000 feet to lose. Which we can do, no problem. start. Right turn. Down to our ships as long as you keep your seat here. So those ships are just there behind this computer screen where I'm pointing. So the rate of descent you've got, you can actually slow it up a little bit. So you've only got 600 feet to lose over the next 3 or 4 miles. 1,800 feet, so don't lose any more altitude. Just go back up here. That's that bush with the checkerboard is illuminated right under my red dot.
Right.
Okay. So you push your nose down. Manual power settings. Just set the and it's gonna be like a chairlift ride, so just okay, left hand down, there's the checkerboard. Just keep going straight towards that because we're a little bit inside the ships, which makes it a sharper turn. Don't lose any more height yet. Focus there. See the strobe lights that guide you in on your turn to the runway. You can see the runway off there to the right. Now, as you come in at a sharper angle, you can actually start your turn now. Night just adds a completely different perspective to things. So what those white lights are saying is we're still a bit high, but in your turn you're going to lose altitude anyway, so don't worry about that. Good instinct, you just pull back on the stick. Turn up. I've got your throttles. Keep your nose coming down there. Roll out of your turn and fly towards the runway. Always use your right pedal to line yourself up, okay? You're a bit, keep yourself coming down. Bit of right turn as well, that's okay. Now start your flare and keep your right pedal. Start flaring with your right pedal, left pedal.
900.
Round to the end now, left pedal.
50.
Nose down, left pedal. That's it.
20.
Remaining. 2,000 remaining. Approaching on runway 3. Caution, short runway, 2,000 remaining.
Park it over there with the freighters.
Sure,
that could be fun. See how you go, doing a right turn over this causeway. Progeny in the making there, but